The 0-2. Left side, Swanson to first. The Braves are world champions.
You saw it right here on Fox 54. The Atlanta Braves are world champions. We have complete coverage as we continue right here on Fox 54 News Now.
And we are live outside SRP Park. Reaction from fans is straight ahead.
Plus, World Series apparel is here. We're live tonight at Academy Sports in Evans, where fans are getting the first dibs on this Braves World Series merch.
Good evening, and thank you so much for joining us. I'm Courtney Hicks. We are so amped. We begin tonight with history in Atlanta as the Braves have won the World Series, as you know, over the Astros, bringing the championship to Atlanta for the first time in 26 years. Game 6 was in Houston, of course, and the Braves made it feel like home. Atlanta starts hot with a home run that brings in 3 runs in the third inning, and before you know it, it was 6-0 in the 5th. Houston would not have an answer to the Braves' hot bats tonight. And Atlanta wins the World Series tonight by a count of 7-0. That was a great moment right there when he just dropped the bat. I think he just knew it was a home run. Now, while the crowds continue to go crazy in Atlanta, they're also going a little wild right here in the CSRA. We have team coverage across the area tonight. Fox 54's Hannah Cotter is standing by at Academy Sports in Evans, where they're opening boxes of World Series apparel. But let's first go to Jared Eggleston. He's been standing by live at Southbound Smokehouse at SRP Park with the fan reactions. And Jared, right before we went to air, there were a few crazies behind you as folks are definitely excited about this World Series tonight.
And Courtney, good evening. It is electric out here. The fans are excited. It is an understatement to say that. They are excited that the Braves, they have a new title tonight. They are World Series champions. Now, that title is the first, this is the first time that they've held that title since 19. Talking, everyone from lifelong fans to brand new fans are celebrating the Braves' win tonight. Now, coming up in the next half hour, I talked to both about their reactions going into the game tonight, and we'll hear their reaction to the win as well coming up in the next half hour. For now, we are live in North Augusta. Courtney, we will send it back to you in the studio.
All right, thanks so much, Jared. The camera's a little excited about the wind as well. He's live from Southbound Smokehouse in North Augusta. We'll check back in with him. We continue our team coverage. Let's take it now to Evans. Fox 54's Hannah Cotter is at Academy Sports, where World Series apparel is ready to hit the shelves, hot out the boxes. Hannah, how's it looking there?
I mean, like you said earlier, the last time you were able to say this was 26 years ago, so fans are so excited to be getting this merch. I grabbed a T-shirt, of course. They're letting in about 20 people at a time because the line was wrapped around the block. I've been talking to people. They're so excited. People are grabbing merch for other people. They're buying stuff for their friends. Someone asked if there's a limit about the stuff that they can buy, so it's just high energy here, and everyone is just so, so excited. Go Braves. Back to you guys.
All right, thanks so much, Hannah. Very exciting and electric tonight as well. We appreciate you. She's out. It's Academy Sports at Evans, and I'm sure they'll be pretty busy tonight. Hold tight. We'll get back to you. Hannah and Jared will be back in the next half hour with more Braves coverage. We want to thank you both. Many Braves fans traveled from near and far to cheer on their favorite team. Fox 54 caught up with Braves fans, Braves fan Andrew Ranson, who, despite never having lived in the Peach State, became a diehard supporter of the team while living in Seattle. He kept a Braves flag in front of his house, and with his flag flying high, he realized the Braves community is strong everywhere. And after attending his first Braves game in LA during the National League Championship Series, Ranson knew what else he had to do.
I think it was such an amazing experience. I couldn't imagine not coming back to the World Series this week. And so bought a ticket, jumped on a plane, and here I am.
Ranson goes on to say that regardless of the ticket prices, getting to the World Series was on that bucket list Prices for games have ranged from $300 all the way to $30,000 as we bring in Jay Jeffries, who was probably the only one here in the newsroom back in 95 when the Braves won the World Series.
Mm-hmm. 27 years here for the CSRA.
Yeah.
They had what it was called a blue law, so not a lot of places were opened up for the World Series, mm-hmm. but people all over the Peach State was just fantastic. They were just like, man, the Braves won. I go like, man, yeah. I'm in Georgia, you yeah. know, so hey, this is
And I'm
it.
Sure the 20-some-odd years ago, the celebration was very different. We yeah. weren't in the digital age just yet, so it was, you know, everybody hitting the pavement.
It was crowds everywhere.
Yeah.
And wherever you looked, there was crowds. There was backyard parties. There yeah. was street parties. There was block parties. Mm-hmm. And there was parties on top of the parties, you know, and everything. So it was fantastic.
Wow.
So congratulations.
All right.
Okay, let's talk about our forecast here for you. We're getting into more of the Braves activity. In the meantime, we have those dry conditions. It's dry and pleasant there in Atlanta. On the chilly side, Thompson, Hepzibah back over to Augusta into the Aiken area. Much of the same there for you, too. So we'll continue with these cooler temperatures across the other CSRA. And, of course, extra hour sleep coming up for this weekend. And then by really cold temperatures are headed our way, and that's basically going to be coming in for the weekend. We could talk about the frost and also into the freeze. Current temperatures now 52 degrees there in Saluda, 52 in Augusta, 57 in Waynesboro, and 54 around the Allendale area. Our dry conditions are continuing. No watches and or warnings across the region. So now the temperatures will be dropping slightly. We'll talk more about that shortly. Here's our hourly forecast at 1 a.m. 58, 54 degrees at 5, and 53 degrees at 9 a.m. tomorrow morning. Courtney, back over to you.
All right. Thank you so much, Jay. Let's get to some headlines this morning. The final election results are in for the new James Brown Arena bond vote. And after a 40-60% vote, the decision to build a new arena has not passed. Fox 54 caught up with the Coliseum Authority after the results came in. Vice Chairman Brad Usry says they're disappointed with the outcome. However, they're committed to getting this building built. They just need to find other funding scenarios, but he understands voters' concerns.
Let's get back to work, make sure we get the building booked and do the best we can with what we have right now. But going forward, we're going to look for other funding, and we're going to meet tomorrow. We've already called a meeting with the authority and to see our next steps.
Now, in addition to this story, we've been telling you about how fans also want to see hockey at the new arena. We caught up with one of the former players who's also spearheading the effort to bring hockey back to Augusta tonight. Steve Munn tells Fox 54, although it didn't pass, they've been exploring other options.
The arena discussion downtown is definitely not finished. It might be postponed by a year or two, but I think that's not a book that's ready to be closed for good.
Munn goes on to say that they aren't discouraged or they're not going to slow down at all with this no vote, and they have some good things in the works. And over to Grovetown, where incumbents Deborah Fisher and Sylvia Martin have been reelected to the city council. Out of 509 ballots cast, Fisher received 31% of the vote and Martin received about 35% of votes. They were up against newcomer Shelley Candian, who previously served on the city's planning commission before deciding to run. Fox 54 caught up with Martin today, a lifelong Grovetown resident who has been a city council member since 2014. She says she knows the city well and has residents' best interests at heart.
I love the city. I am not a newcomer. In fact, I was born and raised here, so I've seen Grovetown grow from a little sleepy town of 800 to 1,000 people to what it is today. So I kind of know the ins and outs.
Deborah Fisher did not immediately respond to our request for comment. She's been serving on the city council since 2018. And the governor's race in Virginia was also underway today, and with both Georgia and Virginia acting as swing states for presidential elections in recent years, Virginia's voting trends could give us some insight into next year's governor election here. Fox News correspondent Madeline Rivera is in Virginia with the state's impact.
Polls closed Tuesday with candidates for Virginia Governor Terry McAuliffe and Glenn Youngkin running neck to neck.
But we still got a lot of votes to count, so we're going to continue to count the votes because every single Virginian deserves to have their vote counted.
Exit interviews showing key issues among voters included the economy, COVID-19, and education. Others saying their decision boiled down to local issues.
We feel pretty darn good, I have to say. So.
Virginia's race garnering national attention, seen as a political bellwether ahead of next year's midterm elections. McAuliffe worked to tie his competitor to former President Donald Trump, whereas Youngkin's campaign saw the race as a referendum on President Biden.
Look, you know, the off year is always unpredictable.
In New Jersey, another gubernatorial race seen as a potential bellwether for voter sentiment, pit Republican gubernatorial candidate Jack Cittarelli against incumbent Democratic Governor Phil Murphy. Meantime, in Minneapolis, voters rejected replacing the city's police department with a new public safety department. Moving forward, the political focus shifts to election 2022 when control of Congress is at stake. All 435 seats in the House will be up for election, along with 34 seats in the Senate. In Washington, Mal Rivera, Fox 54 News Now.
Ooh, you feel that? The excitement in the air. World champions, can't believe it. It's been done. Woo! All right, let's talk about our stats for today. We got up to 77, the norm of 73. We start off at 44. How low will these temperatures go for the rest of the week? We'll answer that question with the 7 day in a moment. Good morning to you once again. We're into the middle of the week and our dry conditions will continue. Turn out to be a beautiful day across the other region again for Georgia and South Carolina. Not really a cloud in the sky, dry conditions continuing, but look to the north of us. That's that colder air will be plunging down. So out of Nashville, as you get into 69, 57, over to 40 and 55, that freeze watch in effect until Thursday at about 9 a.m. And that's going to be a portion of central time. The nation itself with those scattered showers Oklahoma. This is moving into Arkansas, into Missouri. So the rain chances here locally, nothing for today. By tomorrow, Friday, maybe even Saturday, could pick up those scattered showers or two. And much colder temperatures are headed our way, too. We still got to talk about a tropical storm, Wanda. Winds of 50 miles an hour moving off to the north at about 9, but no threat to the U.S. mainland area, and this thing is just crazy. Look at the pattern here for the next 48 hours or so. But the other big story today, we got an afternoon high temperature of 77. Well, that was on Tuesday. But now these temperatures are going to drop. Look at the high temperature on Thursday of only 55 degrees. That's a massive drop here for the southeast region. Currently now we're 52 in Augusta, 56 in Waynesboro, 55 in Aiken, and 52 degrees around, say, Barnwell. Tomorrow, they'll see a high temperature of 61, much cooler. We won't see these 70s for quite some time there for you, the 7 day in a moment. Want to go into the future with this colder air and temperatures are on the way. And matter of fact, as we get closer to the weekend, our rain chances will diminish, but the temperatures will drop closer to the freezing level. Passing shower or two in our forecast for Thursday afternoon into the evening. And some of that moisture will be coming back in to the CSRA there for Friday. So 49 for tonight, northeast wind of 5 to 7 miles an hour. But as we get into, say, a Friday into Saturday, these temperatures will change. So here is our 3 day forecast. Today, partly cloudy to mostly cloudy skies and 63. By Thursday, mostly cloudy to cloudy conditions and only 56 for the high, or 55 depending on where you are. Friday will be cloudy and temperature of 60, but now notice the overnight temperatures. By Saturday, scattered showers, 40% chance, and 59. We're back up to 66 degrees there on Sunday, and then Monday, Tuesday, we look for these sunny skies and temperatures are really nice. As we continue to celebrate the World Series, we're back right after this.
Over my city, on, over my city, I put on for my city, on, over my city. Saluting our heroes, sponsored by Newsom Electrical Construction and the Exchange Club of South Augusta.
And as we continue celebrating the world champion Braves, we also want to focus in and celebrate our first responders, better known as heroes. Now, when you need help during a medical emergency, Lucretia Banks may be the person coming to your rescue. A lifelong dream has now become her mission. Fox 54's New Morning anchor Vincent Hill brings us her story.
I love people, and you know, I love caring for people, doing what I can for people.
Lucretia Banks always knew what she wanted to do when she grew up.
Since I was in high school, I had started out wanting to be an EMS.
And she's been doing it for almost 20 years now, working her way up the ranks. Now she's a captain, but still answers calls.
Still on the truck. From 8 to 8, I do 12-hour shifts.
When asked why she still works as hard as she does, her answer, a simple one.
I won't tell you what to do if I don't do it myself. I want to be an example to the ones that's under me.
The senior director of Gold Cross EMS, John Smith, describes Banks in just one word.
Awesome. Just awesome.
Above all else, Smith says Banks truly cares about the community she serves.
She treats the patients like they're her own family, which really goes a long way toward making people feel comfortable.
Banks says her high school dream has been her passion, thanks to a little help from her faith.
God gave me the capability of doing my job and doing it professionally to see life come back to someone.
Banks says the most rewarding part of her job is being able to give someone a chance at life when the situation may have looked a lot different. Vincent Hill, Fox 54.
Well, it's time now to take a look at our temperatures across the area with our outdoor forecast. And this is being sponsored by Augusta Regional Airport.
Welcome back. As the temperatures continue to drop, make sure you stay warm and cozy with Swiss Miss's classic hot chocolate along with their new sweater. Check it out. The new holiday sweater comes with an insulated pouch that holds your hot chocolate thermos. Okay. The sweater says, "I'm only here for the Swiss Miss," featuring a snowy winter scene and, most importantly, the front pocket that is also designed as a cup of cocoa. The limited edition sweaters can be found on, I was just about to ask, is this going to be like an ugly sweater, Christmas sweater thing? And it is, uglychristmassweater.com. It'll hit you for about $45. I figured, I was hoping it'd be on the ugly Christmas.
So basically they have taken the family fanny pack and put it into a sweater now.
For the most part,
okay.
But Swiss Miss is like, that's a classic, you know, hot cocoa kind of thing.
Yeah, hot cocoa. Yeah, but you're going to need some of that because our temperature is going to be dropping. We hit 77 today.
Yeah. It got nice. I mean, it started off a little crisp, and then by mid-morning, I was ready to take that jacket and sweater off.
Yeah,
so.
But you're going to kind of keep it on down there for you. Take a look at our conditions across the area there. Early Wednesday morning, we continue to be pretty much dry and quiet. From Edgefield, good evening to you. Hepswell, I'd like to say good morning to you. 49 degrees in Fort Gordon, Augusta 52, 54 degrees in Allendale, our friends in Millen of 52, and 54 degrees there in Swainsboro. So here's the hourly forecast. Here's the breakdown. We'll continue with clear skies at around 2 a.m. Northeast wind about 6 and 57. Now the temperature at 6 a.m. getting closer to our sunrise of 54 with a northeast wind about 11. Then 10 a.m. we'll have some sunshine, 53 northeast wind there around 10. And 53 degrees. Where your 7-day forecast is coming up in just a couple minutes there for you.
All right, thanks so much, Jay. Coming up in the next half hour, more Braves coverage that you don't want to miss. Stay with us. We're back right after this. Oh, yes, the Braves are world champions, and the continuing coverage of the win continues right here on Fox 54.
The Braves are officially 2021 World Series champions. We are live with fan reaction coming up.
Hoodies are going to be at the end.
Hey,
Courtney. Yeah, it's been crazy here. This line has not stopped moving since doors opened at 12, and people are stocking up on...
All right, good evening, and thanks so much for staying up with us. We'll get back to Hannah Cotter in just a moment. She's ready to give us the goods out there at Academy Sports in Evanston. As you can see, it is on and popping. Folks are ready for that gear. I'm Courtney Hicks, and yet again, fans are excited about the Braves World Series victory, and we continue team coverage right now. We're going to go back out to Hannah Cotter, where she's now ready to let you know what's happening out there in Evans at Academy Sports. And we tapped into you in the first half hour, and we saw fans just rushing in. And right now, it looks like a full house at, what, 12, almost 20 minutes to 1 in the morning. Hey, Hannah. Oh, we're going to Jarrett?
And good morning, Courtney. I know the excitement is just in the air tonight. Braves fans were optimistic heading into tonight's game, and it is clear that their dreams came true.
The best day in Georgia in probably a long time since the 90s, sir.
Fans here locally and around the country are celebrating the Braves' win over the Houston Astros. Theron Powell plays on Augusta University's baseball team, and he says he is excited to watch the Braves run.
I'm not from Georgia. I'm from Virginia, but I've been in Georgia for 3 years, so all my boys are Braves fans, so I'm just on the wave right now.
Other fans have been watching the Braves for years and even say they remember the last time the Braves were in the World Series.
I mean, they called us the underdogs, but we are dominating the series so far.
The win over the Astros was seen right here on Fox 54 on TVs across the CSRA. Fans began piling into Southbound Smokehouse in North Augusta Monday evening to prepare and cheer on the Braves.
But I mean, halfway through the season, you didn't think we would be here.
This is sensational. Honestly, like, there's goosebumps everywhere, and every time that pitch is thrown, every time that bat is hit, this is something sensational. I cannot believe that we are part of this.
And fans had one final thing to say to close the night out.
Let's go, Braves!
And as you can see behind me, the party, it still continues here at Southbound. I've got some friends that have joined me out here. We are having a great time celebrating the Braves' win and the Braves' new title. For now, we're live in North Augusta. Courtney, we'll send it back to you in the studio.
Eagleston live from Southbound Smokehouse in North Augusta tonight. Thanks, Jarrett. If you're dying to get your hands on some World Series gear, one store in the CSRA has some right now. Let's go to Fox 54's Hannah Cotter, who joins us live now from Academy Sports in Evans as fans are racing into the store to get their hands on these exclusive items. Hannah?
Courtney, as I was saying earlier, this line has not stopped moving since the doors opened at 12, and fans are stocking up on gear, not just for themselves, but for family and friends, too.
I've been getting texts from family and friends of shirts and hats and hoodies that everybody wants, gathering sizes and getting Venmo'd money so I can pay for it.
And so the doors are open, and management tells me that they had to call in all these other employees to stay open late, and it's been a big production, and they put a lot of work into it. So if you want to come down and get your World Series gear, you can come on right now. It doesn't look like the doors are closing anytime soon. Back to you, Courtney.
All right, thank you so much, Hannah, live at Academy Sports in Evans. We appreciate you. And while this isn't the Braves' first time in the World Series, Atlanta's Truist Park got to see the action for the first time. So what did it take to prepare the stadium for a game like the World Series? Fox 54 spoke with Braves officials, and they say planning usually takes months and help from a team with literally hundreds of people. Just a bit of the cosmetic updates included placing World Series logos in front of both dugouts so you could see World Series signage throughout the park and the battery.
The preparations are, you know, significant, and you've seen it just from walking around. You know, we've got the big Fox stage in the battery. We've got roads closed and things going on, and, you know, it definitely takes a lot of planning.
Also, a part of the planning and preparation crew were the cleaners and gift shop workers who arrived early in the morning before each game to clean the unboxed products to make sure fans had an optimal experience.
Good morning once again, and our dry conditions are continuing. Tuesday turned out to be a beautiful day. Monday was fantastic, but things are now on the horizon to change in our forecast. First of all, we'll pick up a little bit more of the cloud cover. Our rain chance will increase, and the other big story will be the temperatures. So cooler temperatures headed our way for today, only in the 60s, overnight temperatures in the 40s. Extra hour of sleep, that's good news, right? We fall back there for Saturday night. When you go to bed, turn your clocks back. Back 1 hour, get that extra hour of sleep. And then finally, the cold temperatures will be upon us. We could see some frost in some of the low-lying areas. More on that in a moment. 49 degrees now at Fort Gordon, 52 degrees in Saluda, McCormick 55, our friends in Waynesboro, 56 degrees. So again, our dry conditions will continue, but then with the cloud cover, rain chance will actually start increasing for you. So the hourly forecast, staying in the 50s throughout the night, 6 a.m. tomorrow morning, 54 and 53 degrees, partly cloudy skies with a northeast wind around 10 miles an hour at 10 a.m. Courtney?
All right, thanks, Jay. Getting you to some other headlines from last evening. Richmond County authorities are investigating a shooting that left one man injured. Deputies responded to the intersection of Northview Avenue and Fleming Street around 5:30 p.m. yesterday evening after reports of a shooting. They found a male victim with at least one gunshot wound. He was taken to a local hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. The suspect, described as a black male wearing a black hoodie, is still at large in this case. Also, Richmond County deputies responded to a residence on the 2300 block of Martin Road at around 6:45 p.m. yesterday evening. Once on scene, officers found 58-year-old Awanda Thomas, who had been assaulted. She was pronounced dead at the scene. This investigation is ongoing, and we have more information about the suspect wanted in this case on our website. That's WFXG.com. Now to Columbia County, where the coroner is investigating a crash that killed two people yesterday afternoon on I-20 between Thompson and Grovetown exits. Details are limited, but we now know a white pickup truck crashed into the back of a flatbed truck. Be sure to download our free Fox 54 News Now app to get the latest details. And the Richmond County Sheriff's Office is investigating a shooting that took the life of a teenager. Deputies were called to this scene here on the 2400 block of Plantation Road Monday evening after reports of a shooting. Police say 16-year-old Tequil Lee Jr. was found with a gunshot wound and taken to a local hospital where he died earlier yesterday morning. No word of a suspect at this time. Fox 54 will keep you updated as we learn more. And another update for you, as we have new photos in the case of a missing Richmond County teen. 15-year-old Blessin Bussey was last seen Thursday. That was October 28th, around 7 p.m. on the 3200 block of Dean's Bridge Road. These are new photographs of the man police say she was seen walking with. Blessin was wearing a black jacket, blue or black jeans, and sneakers. If you have any information on where she may be, please contact the Richmond County Sheriff's Office. And children could in the U.S. could soon line up for a COVID-19 vaccine. The CDC Advisory Committee voted in favor of giving Pfizer's vaccine to kids between ages of 5 and 11. Meanwhile, the battle over vaccine mandates continues across the country. Fox News correspondent Jonathan Siri has more.
A CDC independent advisory panel voting Tuesday to recommend Pfizer's COVID vaccine for children ages 5 through 11. The green light sets the stage for millions of children to roll up their sleeves.
It is our ongoing responsibility to make sure as many people as possible are vaccinated and protected from COVID-19.
Younger children will receive one-third of the dose authorized for Americans 12 and older, and the shots will be delivered by smaller needles. More than 20,000 pediatricians, family doctors, and pharmacies are ready to distribute the shots. Doctors say an endorsement of the vaccine is timely ahead of the winter holidays, when health experts say we could see another spike in infection rates.
Certain surveys have indicated that only 27% of parents are going to let their kids get vaccinated. So that's a very important issue that we have to overcome.
Meanwhile, in New York City, about 1,000 firefighters are on unpaid leave for not complying with the vaccine mandate. The FDNY's commissioner says his department is also seeing a growing number of sick calls, claiming some members are calling out to skirt the vaccination requirement. It's something the union denies.
You would expect medical leave to go up because you have more members doing more work with less companies out there doing more hours.
And today, Pfizer said it's on track to deliver more than 2 billion doses of its vaccine this year. In Atlanta, Jonathan Siri, Fox News.
We'll have more news momentarily. Afternoon high temperature on Tuesday hit 77 degrees. That's warm. That's a few degrees above normal for this time of the year. We start off at 44 under clear skies and no rainfall. Your 7-day forecast is on the way. Here we are now. We've got to talk about the tropics. Remember, we are still in the hurricane season, officially ending on, say, November the 30th of this month. This is Tropical Storm Wanda. This is the last name on our list. 50-mile-an-hour winds moving off to the north at night. But this is crazy, folks. Watch just out there. Just don't know which way it just wants to go, but I do know one thing. It's not going to affect the eastern portion of the U.S. Hold on to your seats. We're on a roller coaster ride when it comes to these temperatures. On Tuesday, we hit a high temperature of 77 degrees. Now, watch these temperatures plunge. This is not going to be the overnight low. This is going to be the high on Thursday, 55 to 56 degrees. So bundle up, grab that coat. You'll need it, especially in the morning hours. We're talking low 40s. Currently now, 54 in McCormick, 52 in Saluda, 55 in Waynesboro, and Thompson there of about 53 degrees. Throughout the southeast, Miami is holding at 75 now. Atlanta, hot Atlanta, we can say that, 51, 56 in Mobile, and Charlotte there of about 51 degrees. Tomorrow, or shall I say today, 61 in Evans, 57 degrees in Saluda, and Columbia there of 57 and 63 degrees around the Millen area. We continue to be pretty much dry and quiet, but we have a freeze watch in effect. This is going to be through the Tennessee Valley area until 9 a.m. on Thursday. A lot of that colder air will be plunging to the southeast. We're going to feel some of that impact as we get deep into the weekend. Now, our rain chances pretty much are picking things up Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. No severe weather is expected, but we're watching this frontal system actually develop. So what's going to happen? We're going to pick up a little bit more of the cloud cover. Our temperatures will be dipping. And, of course, on top of that there for you with the cloudy skies, you can see the scattered showers just ripping through, say, for Thursday. Into Friday, it's going to be partly cloudy conditions. So for the rest of the night, 49, northeast wind of about 5 to 7. Tomorrow or later today of 63, northeast wind of 7 to 10. And then coming up on Thursday, cloudy, 55. Friday, cloudy skies and 60 overnight temperatures, and that's going to be the low 40s with a north wind. Saturday, scattered showers are possible, 59 degrees, and then we bump things up on Sunday, sunny skies, 66, 70 degrees on Monday, and then back up to 74 degrees there a week from today, 74 on Tuesday. All right, we're going to take a look at our tower cam. We're still going to continue to celebrate with the World Series wins from the Atlanta Braves. With midnight train to Georgia, here's Gladys Knight.
He's leaving.
Let's go Braves! WFXG Fox 54 Braves news coverage, sponsored locally by Laurel Wood Equipment.
Atlanta Braves press conference, where Braves player Freddie Freeman is continuing to celebrate this historic win. Let's take a listen.
We hit every pothole, every bump you could possibly hit this year, and somehow the car still made it onto the other side. So it's just an incredible group. What Alex did during the trade deadline, I mean, we've been the best team since the trade deadline. So, and we played like it all the way into the postseason. So we just got hot, and we just carried it over.
Tyler in the third round, and Mark.
Ready, a couple questions, a couple more. What are you going to do with that baseball? You tucked it in your pocket, right?
Yeah, it's hidden somewhere. I think I'm going to give it to Brian. He means so much to this organization. He's put on every hat there is in this organization. And, you know, he was given the job in 2016, and we've delivered four division titles, a world championship, and now he has a manager of the year, too. So it's a pretty good stint so far as Atlanta Braves manager for him.
And you personally, obviously going all the way back to childhood, you've been through a lot in your mm-hmm. life and lost some important people.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think about your mom, your grandma, a time like this?
Yeah. My wife actually texted me before the game telling me that my mom would be so proud and that she's so proud and I love you. And that was at like 5 o'clock. So I didn't really want to think about that at that time because I got a little emotional when I received that text. But seems like my wife is always right to send text messages and calls and let me know encouragement at the right time because it seems to work every time. So believe me, I wish I was able to hug my mom on that field today, but I know she's up with my grandma right now jumping up and down.
Jeff, on your right, guys, third row.
Freddie, I know you said you're still numb, but I'm just wondering, you got a chance to squeeze the last out
mm-hmm.
and just what that felt like at that moment.
It felt real good because when the ball is hit, you know it's going to shortstop with a trajectory and all that stuff. But I didn't know if D'Angelo was going to throw it a second or not. But when I got to first and turned and he started throwing it to me, and I was like, oh, man, I'm going to catch the last out of the World Series. So pretty special. You guys probably seen the video. I put it immediately into my back pocket. Because when we won the NLCS, I just jumped up and just let the ball fly out. So I wasn't going to do it this time. So pretty cool to catch the last out.
Mark, on your left.
Freddie, how good does it feel to know that we'll never be able to ask you about the Atlanta sports narrative?
Yeah, that's nice. understandable of why we get those questions, but we killed the narrative in the NLCS, and we get to kill it.
All right, that was Freddie Freeman. We'll be right back.
Ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Work so hard.
And welcome back. That's going to do it for us finally tonight, Jay Jeffries. Mm-hmm. We're going
to
do some weather first.
Yeah,
okay.
This early morning hours there. Weather now, Doppler radar is up and running from Washington back over to Allendale, Barnwell, and Bamberg.
Look at our temperatures now starting to see those 50s. That's going to be the low 50s throughout the night into early tomorrow morning. But a beautiful skyline there overlooking downtown Augusta. For today, partly cloudy skies, 63, overnight temperature of 41. For Thursday, mostly cloudy skies and 55. Rain chance will actually increase for Thursday, Friday, and also again on Saturday. And that's going to be the last day before we actually fall back. We gain an hour of sleep. We got some showers coming in on Friday into a Saturday. Better chance for that day of 59 and then 66 degrees there on Sunday.
All right, now I can say it. All right, that's going to do it for us tonight. Make sure to join the morning team in like 5 minutes for continuing coverage of the World Series win for the Atlanta Braves. But for now, thanks for joining us. Have a great, Wednesday now? Folks are going to be celebrating all day. It's going to be a good one. All right, we'll see you soon.
Georgia. Georgia. The whole day through,
the whole day,
just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind.
Georgia on my mind.
I said, Georgia, Georgia. A song of you,
a song of you,
comes as sweet and clear as moonlight through the pines.
to reach out to me. Other eyes smile tenderly. Still in the peaceful dreams I see, the road leads back to you. I said, Joe.